y'all. I know my time is always crazy, but what I will tell you is that I'm excited that we are all together. I know you wanted to rock out to the song. You could just hear it lightly playing in the background. Shout out to Cedric, Shannon Reeves, and the brothers. What's up, Mitch? Hey, BFF. Hey, Sed. Hey, Lloyd. What's up, Scooter? What's up, Clee? So I just want to shout y'all out because y'all going to hear this song, Isaiah 40, 31. It's going to be playing soft, though, okay? So I just want to get you started for this week. We're at day one. I tell you, day one, two, three, four, five, six, and then day seven starts a new week. You know, I got to keep myself together as well. I'm praying that you're as excited as I am. This week, we're talking about fervor, right? What does your fervor look like? That's what this week is all about. We are breaking down faith, okay? So if you're new to the 30-day How I Faithed It Over challenge, that's what we could do hashtag 30-day HIFIO, H-I-F-I-O. That might work. This is from this handy dandy book. Can you see the book? Can you see the book? Can you see the book? I know you probably can't see the book, but I wanted to read something from the book. That's why it's kind of good for you to actually have the book as a companion while we're doing this, because I'm going to be touching into each part. But right now, before I read from the book, I wanted to just encourage you, because I know whenever you're starting something new, or whenever you are not necessarily starting something new, but reinforcing. Oh, that's such a good word. Thank you, God. When you are reinforcing what you've already known to be true, what you already have learned. It's difficult sometimes when you have to reinforce those things. So you are going to be looking at faith, maybe a little bit different, right? It's not going to be the same way that you always thought it was, because you have a new definition. We know that faith is a what? Language. Okay? But Jesus spoke it best, okay? And we hear all throughout the New Testament, right? We're reading the New Testament. We hear that faith speak. We hear that faith encouragement. So it's about your language. Remember, it's not heaven's currency. It is God's language. So I'm excited. We're talking about fervor. And I wanted to just talk about my life. Just a quick little story. You'll get little stories. We'll get some Bible. We'll do all those things. You know, growing up, I lost my father when I was about 6 or 7. And I don't remember the exact age. I do remember his date of departure. And I remember just growing up in life feeling like, ugh, I wish I had a dad. You know, I wish I had a father. I wish I had my biological father. And then God sent me a bonus dad, which I was so excited about. Who recently passed as well. So, you know, my whole life has been, even as a young girl, was just a little trying. But my mom used to tell me that throughout my whole experience, all of these experiences in my little life, right? I kept the faith, right? I had this insane knack to always see God in every single situation. She said it was weird because I was so young, and even as I started getting into my high school years and, you know, now adulthood, she said, I've always kept that knack of God's got it. If it's impossible, I know somebody that can fix it. God can do it. And when I realized that was my fervor for God and all of his precepts, concepts, all of those steps that y'all want to bring, right? It was my fervor for him. And, you know, fervor, that root word is fervere. I hope I'm pronouncing it correctly. Now, I took Latin for 4 years, and I think it's fervere. That's how we used to pronounce it when I was in high school. But it's F-E-R-V-E-R-E. And it means to boil. It means hot, right? So when you see the word fervor, when you see the word zeal in the Bible, that's what it's talking about. Are you on fire? Are you hot? All the way to the point of boiling over for God and for everything he has for you. And I realized I've been that way my whole little life. You know, we all have ups and downs, and I'm telling you the truth. This week that we start reading, it's going to be tough for you. It's going to be a challenge. You're going to have ups. You're going to have downs. You're going to have moments, even in a week, where you're going to be like, I don't want to do this faith challenge because I'm being stretched in ways I didn't think I would be able to be stretched. But I'm encouraging you to press forward. And we'll read from the text where I quoted Leviticus 6, 12 through 13. And it said, and the fire upon the altar shall be burning in it. It shall not be put out. And the priest shall burn wood on it every morning and lay the burnt offering in order upon it. And he shall burn thereon the fat of the peace offerings. The fire shall ever be burning upon the altar. It shall never go out. So when we think about this fire, and when we think about being on fire for God, when you see something on fire, there's a couple things, you know, that you do, right? First of all, you're like, oh my goodness, is that a fire? What's the first thing you say? I hope everyone's okay. I hope everyone's okay. Next thing that you do, if you're close enough or in, you know, in the proximity where you're actually there when the fire is, you may call for help, right? You may pick up the phone and go, oh my goodness, I see a house on fire. I see a car on fire. We need help immediately, right? The other thing you do is you walk away. And the reason why you got to get away is because a fire is what? It's hot, right? So imagine, just put on your imagination cap. I don't know what we're going to call it. We're going to figure out a name for imagination, but go ahead and put that on. Now imagine if you walk every single day of your life from this point on fire, literally. For the Father and for everything that He has for your life, for your family, for your business, for your ministries. There's going to be some things that people are going to do. People will see you on fire and they have to make a choice. What are they going to do? Right? Are they going to say, oh my goodness, I hope everything's okay? They are going to say, I hope everything's okay, because you got a new language. You got a new way of walking. You got a new way of living. So yes, people are going to be like, are you okay? I hope everybody is okay. Yes, I'm okay. Right? Then they're going to call for help. Right? And that's normally the gossip. That's the gossip train. I want to be clear. That's for people that's gossiping about how you changed and how you're on fire and how something is different. They're not going to call you. They're going to gossip about you. So I want you to be clear on who's talking, huh? And then the other thing they're going to do is they're going to leave. And on that, that's when you shout. Because that fire is getting everybody and everything that don't belong around you out the way. So for this week, I want you to stay grounded. I want you to stay excited about this journey. 30 days of straight faith is going to change your life. Stay fervent in everything you do. All right? I can't wait to see you tomorrow. I don't know. Sorry about that. But yeah, I'll see y'all later. Peace. But can we listen to the brothers on the way out though? Can we listen to them on the way out? Weekend. I'll see you tomorrow, guys.
He's gonna make a way. He's gonna see you through. He's right there opening doors for you. He's gonna bring you out. He's gonna make a way. He's gonna see you.
I know you don't wanna leave me either.
Opening doors for you.
Come on, y'all.
He's gonna bring you out.
What? Make it personal.
Yeah.
All right.